Hello everyone. So in this video, I will be teaching you about the basic SQL commands and statements. For this, I will be using MySQL Workbench. So MySQL Workbench is nothing but a tool that allows us to run and execute SQL commands, and it helps us to learn easily. Okay, so first just open MySQL Workbench. So in this tutorial, we will be covering basic statements like create, insert, update, delete. And I think it's suitable for beginners of MySQL, or even though you are intermediate, you can just try and watch this video. Just open MySQL Workbench and go and click this connection. Okay, and you will get a setup new connection option over here. Just type any name. Okay, I will type as new con, as new connection. And if you want, you can give a password. I'm not giving it. Just click OK. So as you can see here, our new con connection is created. Double click it. And it will ask you a password. This password is the password that you have given when you have installed your MySQL Workbench. So I will just type it and hit OK. So that's your or say a new connection workbench over here. So first, before creating a table directly, we need to create a database. And inside the database, we will be creating a table. So for creating a database, it is create database and database name. I will give the database name as newestdb. Okay. So one thing good about SQL is that the commands and statements are direct translate from English language. So even though if a person sees this create database, that statement, he can easily understand what is the purpose of the statement. So that's a really good thing about SQL. So just type it and hit run. Okay, this run basically executes whole statements, and this run icon over here executes only a part of statement that is below the under the keyboard cursor. Okay, we were going to use only this statement, and I will show you how to use this statement for all the things. Just hit run. So as you can see here at the down action or output bar, you will be getting this green tick, which means that your database has been successfully created. So now if you just go to schemas over here, so this will display the number of databases over here, but our newest database has been created, but it is not available over here. So just refresh it, and as you can see here, our newest DB database is available. Okay, it's now empty because we don't have any tables in it. And next thing what we need to do is we will be instructing MySQL Workbench that I am going to use this particular newest database. Okay, so for that you need to type use newest db. Okay, you need to be careful with the spelling newest db. And now if you hit run, you will be getting an error because this run basically executes both the statements, but our first statement is already there and we have newest db. So if you again try to create another database of newest db, it will throw you an error. Now let me show you. I'm not setting anything, just hit run. So as you can see here, I'm getting an error because can't create database newest db because database already exists. So how to solve is that by running only the second line. So to run only the second line, just copy the second line and hit run. Okay, so now you can see here we are not getting any error and our database has been selected. So this is basically like using the cd command in Linux. I'm saying this is my directory and like that. Okay, so now let's just create a table. First option is creation. So for creating a table, create table and table name. I will name the table as student, and I'll be putting role. So student, we are just going to, as a sample, I will put a role number and a name. So role number, that is a variable or a column name and call over, and it's going to be of int data type, integer. And primary key. Okay, I will tell you what is this primary key. So primary key is a unique key for each column or each value, using which we can identify. So in our case, roll number is a primary key because in a school, two or more students can have the same name. So it becomes really difficult to identify even they have same name or initial, even sometimes they have the same date of birth. So in that case, their roll number is unique. Even though they have a same name, their roll number helps us to identify them uniquely. So that's the same thing to enroll in a primary key also. Primary key helps us to identify each record uniquely. Okay. Next, the name, and it's going to be varchar. Varchar is like string. Okay, string data type, and specify the length. I will just specify 15 and okay. So we aren't getting any errors. So now we are going to execute only the third line. So select the third line and hit run, and it's running, and we got a green tick, so it hasn't got any errors. So now to display the table, select asterisk from student, the table name. Okay, so this command basically over here displays the entire table and its contents, but we have now got, we have an empty table, we have only assigned the column names. So even though if you run it, we will be getting a blank table with only columns. Okay. So as you guys here, we have null, 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 nothing is there. We have only the column names over here. So don't worry, we will be inserting some values. Okay, so to insert values, what we need to do is, I will just minimize it. Okay, it's going to be insert into, so insert into table name. So table name is student. Insert into table values. Okay, values, that values keyword is important. And here we'll be inserting in a form of, we are going to insert two things. One is a roll number, another is a name. So roll number I will put 1, and I will type one comma, and I will type some name. I will type John something. So this two, this is a int, this is a string, int and string. This should directly correspond to the, just swap it. So this should directly correspond to the, correspond to this create table. Okay, so now if you just execute this command, I will be having one row and column. So if I try to execute this command again, we will be getting an error because primary key is unique. Okay, no two row or column, row to row can have the same primary key. So if I select this and run it again, we will be getting an error because as you can see here, error code duplicate entry. Okay, so this is because a primary key can be unique. We have already got a primary roll number of 1, so we will just put 2 and we will change it as what to say, rabbit, something like that, and just copy this and execute it. Okay, so we are just after it. So now we can check how our table looks. Select this fourth line and run it. So we have 2 rows, 1 to roll number. Okay, so that's insert. So like this you can insert many things. Now update, so it's going to be update and the table name. So the table name is student, and set is used change the value. So here I'm going to change the name. Okay, set name as equal to, another thing, important thing is that every time string should be specified inside double quotes. Okay, and integers without any quotes. I will change the name as from David to David. Okay, and where we are passing the condition where r number equal to 2. Okay, so it's plain, it's been just translated in English and it's basically very easy. So we are changing the name as David, where we are setting the, now changing the name David, where roll number is 2. So basically for instead of David, we'll be getting the name as David. Just copy it and run. So it's, I think it's successfully executed. So now if we select asterisk from student. Okay, so as you can see, we have changed the name from David to David. So that's how it works. Okay, update. So these are just the basics. I'm explaining just the plain basics. So there are many more in-depth concepts, okay, available. And so you have seen create, insert, update, and delete. So next thing is going to be our, so we have seen, okay, next thing, last thing is going to be our delete, okay. So there are two types of delete basically, delete and drop. So delete basically empties the table, but it doesn't remove the table from the database. Whereas drop, it completely removes the table and its contents from the database. So I will do delete first because we can't do drop. Okay, so it's going to be delete from student. Okay, select this, run it. Now just select it and run it. So I think we'll be getting a green. So as you can see, we got a green tick. So now if you go and check the our table, select this and run it. So we will be getting a blank table, but we have our columns left. Okay, so as you can see, we have row number and column number left. But now if we do drop, our table gets completely removed. So just go down and type drop table. So both have different syntax, student. Okay, so now if you just run it, and if you just go down over and see, drop student table has been run. And now if we search this command, we will be getting an error because the table has been completely removed from our database. As you can see here, we aren't getting that output representing rows and columns, and we just go down over here, the NoSQL doesn't exist. So that's what I said, the table is completely gets removed from the database by using drop. So these are the basic SQL commands, create, insert, update, and delete. We have seen this video, and I will be also doing many subsequent manipulations, many advanced SQL commands tutorials. So please subscribe my channel and also check out my other videos, 7-minute tutorials in C, C++, Java, Unity, Blender, Game Dev, Animation, etc. Kindly check those videos out, and thanks for watching.